that you are a child of God, that you have eternal life, that Jesus loves you. Not only that, those of you that are watching right now, I want you to get ready, because the living Lord Jesus Christ is going to come with His power right when we begin to pray, and you're going to be healed. If there's physical sickness in your body, if there's mental depression in your mind, if there's cancer or any of these kinds of things, the Lord Jesus Christ defeated all of these things at the cross. If you study the book of Ephesians especially, the Bible teaches that when Jesus went to the cross, we went to the cross. When Jesus died, we died. When Jesus was buried, we were buried. When Jesus was raised from the dead, we were raised from the dead. When Jesus sat at the right hand of the Father, He made us to sit together with Christ in heavenly places, far above all the realm of the demons. And because of the cross, sin cannot have dominion over you. Because of the cross, demons cannot have dominion over you. Because of the cross, disease cannot have dominion over you. Because of the cross, witchcraft cannot have dominion over you. Because of the cross, curses cannot have dominion over you. Because of the cross, depression cannot have dominion over you. Because of the cross, poverty cannot have dominion over you. Because of the cross, loneliness and rejection cannot have dominion over you. Because of the cross, we have victory in Jesus Christ. That does not mean we won't have problems. We will have problems. Jesus said in John chapter 16, verse 33, in this world you will have tribulation. But He also said, be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Praise God. And 1 John 5, verse 4 says, this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. Our faith in what Jesus did for us on the cross, we can enforce our victory over sin, our victory over demons, our victory over disease, our victory over poverty, and He's given us the name of Jesus. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 2, verses 9 to 11, God has so highly exalted Jesus that He's given Him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess, and that He is Lord to the glory of God the Father. We have the use of the name of Jesus against evil powers. We've got the use of the name of Jesus to access heaven, to the throne of God in prayer. We have the name of Jesus to stand against every force of darkness, praise God. And these signs will follow us because we're believers in Jesus Christ. So I began to learn about these truths. And as I learned about these things, that on the same day that when Jesus went to the cross, He not only took upon Himself our sins to make us righteous in Him, He not only took upon Himself our diseases and sickness so that we can be healed by His stripes, He not only became a curse for us at the cross, that we might be redeemed from all the curses, that the blessings of Abraham might come upon us through faith in Christ. He not only did all of those things, but on the cross, He defeated the devil for us, and He gave us authority over the enemy. And He said, go into all the world and preach the gospel. And by the grace of God, in the last 38 years, I've been to 60 nations of the world, and I've been able to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. Hundreds of thousands of people have received Jesus into their lives, transformed by the power of God. Hundreds of thousands of people have been healed of all kinds of sickness, all kinds of disease. Every day these miracles take place. Every day the Lord Jesus Christ with His living presence begins to manifest Himself through the gifts of the Holy Spirit, through answered prayer, and so many things like this. Even an opportunity to come to the studio here to minister the Word of God is also an answer to prayer, because I always pray, God, I acknowledge You in all my ways. You direct my steps, praise God. And I always say, when you learn how to be a friend of God, God will then introduce you to His other friends. That's how I got to meet all of these friends over here in the studio. Praise God. When we acknowledge Him, He directs our steps. Praise God. And we've seen so many thousands of miracles, cancer miracles, blind eyes opening, deaf ears opening, all kinds of wonderful, wonderful miracles. But you know, the greatest miracle is not a financial miracle. It's wonderful. The greatest miracle is not a healing miracle. That's wonderful. The greatest miracle is when you open your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ and you invite Him into your life. Praise God. So that's the way I began to find some answers as I poured out my heart to God in college. And then I joined up with Dave Roberson on the west coast of the United States, and we traveled all over Oregon and California. And I began to see a demonstration of God's power, miracles, and supernatural gifts of the Holy Spirit. This man, he had what is called the gift of the word of knowledge. And he would be able to look at total strangers and through x-ray vision, explain to them what was wrong with them, what is hurting them in their physical body. And then the power of God will come and heal them. So I had the privilege of traveling with him and living with him for 1 year. And God received the training and supernatural empowerment. Then I left the West Coast, came to the East Coast of the United States, New Hampshire. and Vermont. And then from there, you know, since 1976, I began to spread out all over the United States and many countries of the world. You know, there's an old song. It's a beautiful song. It says, every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. And I have to say that even though I went through many, many difficulties, many sufferings, which I'll talk to you about in a few moments, in spite of all of that, after 38 years serving the Lord in ministry, but actually it's more like 46 years since I've accepted Jesus into my life, every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. Praise God. He's so real. He's so wonderful. And He loves you. He loves you so much. And I want to share a little bit with you that even while I was serving the Lord in the ministry, there were some people that came into my life that were not good people. And they were using the ministry as a way to exploit people through their evil. Some of them were involved in witchcraft, in Satanism. This is in the United States. And they began to do some things and turn the whole group into like a demonic cult, where they began to destroy the lives of people, and nearly 30 families were destroyed, and so many people's lives were really, really affected. And when I stood up against all of those kinds of things, then they used their evil powers to focus upon me and to try to destroy me, my family, my health, my finances, my ministry, my future. And it was the beginning. So I went through 20 years of tremendous suffering. And so I didn't know what happened. I went into deep depression. I just had so many experiences of attacks of satanic nature. And I did not know what to do. But you know what? About 10, 11 years ago, God spoke to me through a videotape of a man of God. And He began to explain some things to me. All of a sudden, I began to understand. Jesus said, you'll know the truth and the truth will set you free. Suddenly, I began to understand, praise God. You know, this man said, Satan has no control over your life except for the lies that you believe. Now, that's very important for you to understand. Satan has no control over your life except for the lies that you believe. And so he said that many times we believe lies. Sometimes people think, demons are the problem and deliverance is the solution. He said, that's not true. Demons are there because of the problem, and the problem is the lies that we believe. If you go to a garbage dump and you see there's a lot of rats there, you take a big stick and you start chasing all the rats away, and you saw all the rats run. Maybe you killed two or three rats while you're just chasing them away, but you saw all the rest of them run away, and you think you have the victory, but after you leave that place, what happens? During the nighttime, all those rats come back. Why? Because the problem is still there. You see, many Christians believe that demons are the problem and deliverance is the solution. That's not true. The demons are there because of the problem, and the problem is the lies that we believe. In Ezekiel chapter 13, verse 22, God rebuked the leaders of Israel for using witchcraft and divination to bring bondage into the lives of God's people. And He said, with lies, you've made the hearts of the righteous sad when I have not made them sad. In other words, at the bottom of every negative emotion, at the bottom of every bondage, whether it's addiction to alcohol, pornography, or drugs, or any kind of things, or witchcraft attack, at the bottom of all of these things, somehow there's a subtle lie that we've believed. And if we can ask the Holy Spirit to show us, Lord, what is it? Where is this thing coming from? You know, God will expose the lies of the enemy. Sometimes those lies are planted even in childhood. Sometimes when we go through a very traumatic experience, the enemy puts lies into our lives and we start believing it subconsciously. And it becomes like a self-fulfilling prophecy, just like the time of Job in the Bible. Job said, that which I feared greatly has come upon me. So sometimes we believe lies, and that cause fear, that cause trouble, cause depression, cause sickness, all of those kinds of things. But today, I'm here to tell you, the Lord Jesus Christ has brought me through all those years of difficulty. Because I once again, that's the reason why I speak very fervently about the cross of Jesus Christ. Because at the cross, everything that you and I will ever go through was defeated at the cross. And our faith in Jesus Christ and His resurrection will enforce those truths so that sin, demons, witchcraft, any of these things cannot have dominion over us. Praise God. I've had the opportunity to write a book about my experiences. And We originally called it How to Release God's Ability Within You, but we've now renamed it called Rebuilding the Foundation of Faith. And so towards the end of this program, you can find out information, how to be in touch with us, our website and our ministry, and how to order books and CDs and DVDs and those kinds of things. And you can rebuild your life, no matter what the enemy has done. You know, the Lord spoke to me some years ago. He said, I'm giving you two promises. I will make up to you for the years that the enemy has stolen, and I will give you beauty for ashes. And in the last few years, as God has been, that's exactly what God has been doing. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm 64 right now. It doesn't look like it, but I feel like I'm 44. He's making up for the years that the enemy has stolen. Praise God. And once again, God's opening all kinds of doors, all kinds of miracles, because Jesus Christ is real. He's really Lord. Praise God. In a few moments, I'm going to give you an opportunity to receive Jesus Christ into your life. That's the greatest miracle. So I want you to get ready. After that, I'm going to get ready to pray for you to receive healings and miracles in your life. Yes, He's going to heal you even while you're watching this. Praise God. I remember a few years ago, I was in the city of Chicago. I finished a meeting and somebody said, there's a woman sitting in the back. She's actually laying down. We want you to pray for her. This woman was so skinny. She was born with AIDS. She was so skinny and born with AIDS, and the doctors told her she has 3 weeks to live. She's all skin and bones, very skinny. She's about 25 years old. She's so skinny. And so I told her to sit up. So with great difficulty, she sat up. I said, please stand up. And with great difficulty, she stood up. And I began to explain the word of God to her, told her what Jesus did for us at the cross, told her about Psalm 103, verses 1 to 5. How Jesus, through the cross, is reflected in Psalm 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. Forget none of His benefits. Who heals all your diseases. Who forgives all your sins. That means all of our diseases are taken care of at the cross of Jesus Christ. Sometimes we think about all these new diseases. What about diabetes? What about AIDS? What about Ebola? What about swine flu and all those kinds of things? No. It says all these diseases, praise God. You can come up with any name that you want to, but at the cross of Jesus Christ, everything was taken care of. So I explained the scriptures to her, and I began to pray for her. And I cursed the root of those AIDS in the name of Jesus, and I commanded the virus to die in the name of Jesus, the HIV virus. And I just said, sister, why don't you lift your hands up and begin to thank God for your healing? So with great difficulty, she started to thank God for her healing, but she was still so skinny, so weak, and she could hardly stand up. I said, now I want you to start walking. So she started to walk. And I said, start saying, thank you, Lord, for my healing. Thank you, Lord, for my healing. So she began to walk with great difficulty. Well, about 5 months later, I was back in the city of Chicago, but I was preaching in another church. At the end of that service, a lady came to me, running to me after the meeting. Her face was full of the glory of God and energy. She came running to me and she said, do you know who I am? I looked at her and I said, no, ma'am, I don't know. I looked at her again and it was the same lady. I said, sister, is that really you? She said, yes. I said, how do you feel? She said, watch me. And she started running around the building. And I said, have you had the doctors check you? She said, yes. And they've given me a written document, no sign of AIDS. Isn't Jesus wonderful? Praise God. Today, you may be suffering from sickness of any kind, whether it's diabetes, whether it's cancer, whether it's deafness, whether it's blindness, whether it's dumbness, whether it's AIDS, whether it's Ebola, it does not matter. Whether it's pain in your body, arthritis, or it's depression in your mind, oppression, maybe you're suffering because of witchcraft. I want you to know that Jesus Christ loves you. So I want you to get ready. When we get ready to pray for your deliverance, pray for your healing, expect the power of God to come upon you. Praise God. All right, so I want you to get ready. First of all, the most important miracle in your life. All of you that are listening right now, the most important miracle is to receive Jesus Christ as the Lord of your life. You see, the Bible teaches there's a real hell and that's forever. The Bible teaches there's a real heaven and that's forever also. Jesus said, unless a person is born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. And you know, you may have respect for Jesus, love for Jesus, But you have to make a decision to invite Jesus Christ into your life. A man and a woman that are in love with each other, respect each other, honor each other, appreciate each other, but that does not make them married until, as an act of their will, before God and before man, they proclaim, I accept you as my wife. I accept you as my husband. And so the Bible calls our union with Jesus Christ a spiritual marriage with him. It's also called being born again. So you may love Jesus, you may respect Jesus, you may honor Jesus, but that's not enough. You need to take one more step and say, I accept Jesus. I invite him to be the Lord of my life. And so that's what I want to pray for you right now. So I want you to get ready. All of you that are listening right now, I want you to get ready. This is the most important decision of your life. So I want you to say this right now. Say, Lord Jesus. That's right. Those of you that are listening, say, Lord Jesus, I open my heart to you. That's right. Say, I open my heart to you. Lord, come into my heart. That's right. Keep saying it. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me of all my sins. Wash me by your precious blood. I believe in my heart Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. I confess with my mouth Jesus Christ, he is my Lord. I believe I'm born again. I believe my sins are forgiven. I believe I'm washed in the blood of Jesus. I believe I have eternal life. I believe I am born again. If you've prayed that prayer, you have made the most important decision of your life. Now, I want to pray for you for other areas of your need also. Get ready to receive healing miracles, deliverance miracles, witchcraft deliverance, all of those kinds of things. If you have pain in your body, get ready for the pain to disappear from your body right this moment. All right, but I want you to repeat this prayer after me, please. All of you that are sick and have pain in your body, arthritis, cancer, disease, whatever it might be, say this after me. Say this loudly. Say, Lord Jesus, I open my heart to you. I receive my healing, not tomorrow, not late tonight, not 5 minutes from now, but right at this moment, in the name of Jesus. Your word says, when you went to the cross, you took all my sickness, all my disease, all my pain, and your word says, by your stripes I was healed. I choose to believe your word is true. I choose to believe I have been healed. So I believe right now that I now receive healing from my body in the name of Jesus. So I thank you, Lord, for healing me. Go ahead and say, thank you, Lord, for healing me. 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 Now I want you to say this. Say, every sickness. Go ahead, repeat. Every sickness, every disease, every pain in my body, I'm speaking to you in the name of Jesus. You don't belong in my body. And in the name of Jesus, I demand, get out of my body right at this moment in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Say, thank you, Lord, for my healing. Go ahead. Thank you, Lord, for my healing. Keep saying, thank you, Lord, for my healing. Thank you, Lord, for my healing. And while you're thanking God for your healing, begin to do what you couldn't do before. Begin to move your hands. Begin to move your head. Begin to move your shoulders. Bend down, touch your toes. Move your legs. Move your back. And just aggressively move your body and do the things you couldn't do before. And keep saying, thank you, Lord, for my healing. Thank you, Lord, for my healing. Thank you, Lord, for my healing. Satan and every demon of sickness, disease, witchcraft, I bind you in the name of Jesus, and I release the power of the Holy Spirit and the angels of God to dismantle all of those things from the multitudes of people that are listening right now in the name of Jesus. Satan and every demon of witchcraft, sorcery, black magic, curses controlling the hearts, minds, lives, families, and the finances of the people, I bind you. I bind you. I bind you in the name of Jesus. Now release the power of the Holy Spirit and the angels of God to dismantle every curse and let the blessings of God come upon their lives. Satan and every demon controlling deafness and dumbness and blindness, I bind you. I bind you in the name of Jesus. Now release the power of the Holy Spirit to orchestrate complete healing. Let them see in the name of Jesus. Let them hear. Let them speak in Jesus' name. Satan and every demon of cancer, I bind you. I bind you. I bind you in the name of Jesus. Now release the power of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. and the angels of God to dismantle all cancer. Satan, every demon controlling Ebola and AIDS and contagious disease, I bind you. I bind you in the name of Jesus. I bind you in the name of Jesus. Now release the power of the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name to resolve and dissolve the root of those conditions in Jesus' name. Now I want to pray for your families and your finances. Poverty is not of God. And if you're stuck in bondage to debts and burdens and depression, oppression, and poverty and all these kinds of things, Satan, every demon of poverty and lack and debts and bondage and crisis financially, I bind you. I bind you. I bind you in the name of Jesus. Now release the power of the Holy Spirit to orchestrate blessings and prosperity for these people. Satan, every demon of oppression, depression, fear, and anxiety, I bind you in the name of Jesus. Now release the power of the Holy Spirit to orchestrate complete deliverance. Cover them by the blood of Jesus in the name of Jesus. I love you. Jesus Christ loves you. And it's so good to be able to talk to you over this program. And I want you to please make sure that you write to us, communicate with us, email us, contact us through our website, augiedavid.org. And also write to us about our book, you can release God's power within you. That's the old title, but it's called Rebuilding Your Foundation of Faith. God bless you. I hope to hear from you soon.